Hello students, how are you? I hope you all are fine at home. So as I told you that MySQL query syllabus is over as per your class plus one. So whatever will come next, that will come in your class plus two. So today I am going to start Python. Okay, before starting the Python, I want to give you the introductory lecture on the Python. First of all, Python. What is Python? Python. It is a programming language. It is an open source. Open source programming language, as well as high level programming language. Okay, so before discuss this, I want to tell you, you have to learn the three things. One is program, one is programming, and one is programmer. Okay. Now, what is a program? A set of instructions is called a program. Okay. Next is a programming. Let me write the definition, then I'll explain you. Programming, to convert the high level language, HLL stands for high level language, into the computer understandable language is called programming. Okay, now what is programmer? The person who do programming is called programmer. Okay, dekho bete, a set of instruction is called a program, which means that computer has its own IQ level 0. Computer has no IQ. It process according to your instruction. Means each and everywhere computer will perform something according to your instructions. For example, program hota kya? Program basically the executable codes. Program basically the executable codes. Now, if I say you want to make 2 plus 3, that means 2 plus 3 karana hai, so this instruction you have to give to the computer. Then only you can get the addition of these two numbers. Means 2, 3 are the numbers. In between, you have to put the plus sign, because it processes according to the instruction given to you. So that means aap usko instruction de rahe ho ki plus sign dala hai ki aap iska plus karo. Suppose instead of that you put multiply, then it will multiply these two values. So program is a set of instruction. Okay, or we can say program are the executable code. Okay, there are various languages which we are using nowadays, like Python, C, C++, okay, to develop the softwares. Now I just give you the live example of this. Set of instruction is called a program. For example, there is an annual function in your school. That means annual function whole is a program. What are the instruction in between? What are the instruction under that? Ki in the annual function, there will be a prayer song. There will be a prayer song. Then after that, there will be the play. And after that, there will be the Kathak dance or whatever the instruction is there. That means wo program, annual function kya ek program hai. Uske andar jo instruction hai, that is set of instruction. So set of instruction is called a program. Now programming, to convert the high level language into the computer understandable language is called programming. Okay, dekho Rajay, you know that computer understand only the binary language. Which language? Binary language. Computer with understand which language? Binary language. But the programming which we are doing in high level language. High level language, it is a just like the English language. Means we are writing our course into the high level language. But computer understand the only the binary language. So to convert हमारी लैंग्वेज को कंप्यूटर को समझाना इज कॉल्ड प्रोग्रामिंग. इन सिंपल वर्ड्स, टू कन्वर्ट द हाई लेवल लैंग्वेज इनटू द कंप्यूटर अंडरस्टैंडेबल फॉर्म व्हिच इज बाइनरी फॉर्म, दैट इज कॉल्ड प्रोग्रामिंग. अब करता कौन है? हु डू दिस वर्क? ओके, टू डू दिस वर्क वी हैव द ट्रांसलेटर सॉफ्टवेयर. ओके, translator softwares which we have two types. One is a interpreter, then the second one is a compiler. Okay, now dekho, I before explaining this I just give you the example. Let's say A and B, they are two persons. A person A knows French, person B knows Hindi. My question is to you people, can they communicate to each other? Some will say no, but some will say yes. Those who say yes, I'm the one of them, I say yes. How? They can only communicate if they have the translator C, who knows both. Means C is a translator which explain to A and B. Okay, that means an intermediate. Same way yahan pe bhi hamari language computer ko samjhane ke liye we have the translator softwares. Okay, one is an interpreter. In Python we are using interpreter. In other language C, C++ we have compiler. There it translates line by line. Okay, compiler, it translates whole page at one time. Okay, this is the difference. At one time it translates whole page at one time. Okay, interpreter, it translates line by line. Compiler translates whole page at one time. Okay, so in Python which translator is there? Interpreter. Okay, which convert your code into the computer understandable form. Programmer is very clear to you. The person who do the programming is called programmer. Because if you people are writing the code, that time you are the programmer. If I am writing the code, I am the programmer, in that way. Okay, I hope this is clear to you. Now I am going to tell you the Python. Python is an open source programming language as well as the high level programming language. Okay, high level kya hai? Just like English language. Okay, but in this language we have to follow, there are lot of high level languages are there in market. C, C++, Java. Okay, then we can say JavaScript also, but that is a web programming. There are lot many are there. So in that way why Python high level language? B, high level language is a language we have to follow certain rules and regulation according to the language. For example, if you see, you learn the English language, English language has its own rules, means own grammar, own words, own sentences. Okay, so in that way, same way each high level language has its own rules and regulations which we need to follow whenever we are writing the codes. Okay, open source ka matlab hota hai Rajay, it provides you free of cost. Okay, it provides you free of cost. There is no charge for that. You can simply download from anywhere and there is no copyright for that. It is open source. Okay, now Python. Dekho Rajay, Python is a language which is used to develop a software, which is used to develop an app, which is used to develop a game, which is used to develop a website, which is used in data science, which is used in artificial intelligence. So this is the language which is very popular nowadays. Even it is used in the Google. Okay, it is used in the Google. Google is using Python nowadays. So that's why it's very interesting language. If you learn it carefully, you will get more benefit in your future. Okay, so I hope this is clear. Python is a high level language that uses, I already told you, to do the programming. Okay, now hum Python kyun use kare? Why Python? The question is, why Python? Python, why Python means hum Python kyun use kare? Answer for this is due to its features, due to its wonderful features, due to its wonderful features. Okay, now you see, first of all, it is easy to learn. Easy to understand. Okay. Easy to implement. Okay. As well as platform independent interpreter. Interpreter. These features makes this more users. First of all, it's easy to learn, easy to understand, easy to implement. Okay, this is mainly simple feature. Ek to learn karna easy hai, isko implementation easy hai, and user can implement in any platform. This is called platform independent, which means suppose I'm using Windows, somebody else is using Mac operating system, that is Apple's operating system. That means, it does not mean if the code is developed in Microsoft Windows operating system, it cannot run there. It also runs there. So that is platform independent. It is also interpreter. Interpreter, I told you, there is translator is a interpreter. Means if you do the mistake, interpreter read your line by line. Okay, so that means if you're doing the mistake, it show you the error there ki this is the mistake. Okay, so that's why it is the interpreted language. Okay student, now I'm going to tell you how you will download the Python. It's very easy. Open the Google. Okay, now you have to write here open google.com. Okay, google.com. Here you have to write free download Python. Then you have to click here the first one. Then there is a, this is the latest version. You have to click over there. Okay, after clicking this, you have to come down. After this, when you comes down, here is a one executable installer file is there. You have to click over there. When you click over there, your file is downloading. Your file is started downloading. Okay, then you have to click. Okay, I already have, I just tell you how to install this. So open. When you open this, if you see, bete, how to install this. By default, this is the interface to install. When the file is downloaded, you can open that. You have to tick this. Make sure the second option, add Python 3.8 to path, must be ticked. You have to tick on this, click on this install now, then it will, installation will start. It will take some time and accordingly that it will install. I'm not going to install here. You can install by ticking on this or by clicking on this, because I already have. That's why I'm not going to install this. Okay, so how to install this, how to run this means how to start Python. You have to start IDLE, IDLE, after installation. You just search IDLE. You have to click over here. My version is 3.6. Now, you see, this is the starting of Python. This is called shell. Okay, this is called shell, as well as it is a kind of interactive mode. Okay, there are two modes in Python. One is an interactive mode, another one is a script mode. And this is called interactive mode. First of all, when you start IDLE, then you will get this window. This is called, this prompt is called shell, 3 > sign. Whatever you want to do, suppose I'm using as a calculator, say 10 plus 5, immediately 15 is the answer. Say 3, 30.2 plus 96, so it will give you the answer. Say 5 multiplied by 8, so it will give you the answer. Say this one divided by 23, so in that way it will give you the answer. This is the instant mode. Say you print, say print bracket start hello. So if you want to print something, dekho, have print hello print karaya, immediately it prints. Print statement is used to print a message or output on screen. So in interactive mode, when you want to get the instant output, then you can use this mode. Okay, but mostly we will use script mode, where we will write our code first and we are able to run that code. So I'm going to tell you how to start the script mode. File, new file. So new file matlab ek nayi file khul jayegi, where we are typing our code, then we will implement. So after opening this, you can close the behind one. Now you see it is open. So I'm going to use print statement. I'm again telling you, print statement is used to print something, print a message, print a statement, or to print the output in Python. So whenever you use print statement, I'm printing hello, I'm doing Python one message, put round bracket, which is available on 9 and 0 opening, then quotes, double quotes shift ke saath, hello I am doing Python. Okay, then close it, then is a print, it is easy to learn. Okay, say this two line I want to print. How to run this? You have two options, click on run, then click run module, or you can press F5. I'm going to press F5. Click OK. Now you see, one more time I want to tell you, when you press F5, it tells you source must be saved. Source matlab a program bana rahe, this is called source, ki iska source aayega kahan se. This is your source file, matlab wo bol raha hai ki your file must be saved. So when you click OK, it say you to save that file. So let's say I'm going to save it hello, is name se save kar raha hu, that is your choice. Python, you just give the name, extension will be taken by Python automatically, but keep it in mind, the extension of the Python file is .py. So just click save. So this, you can see this is printed. Okay, so in that way you can print something. Okay, suppose this bracket I forgot to put. Now I press F5, that means I did a change. Again it says please save the changes. Okay, now you see it is error, kyunki you have to follow the rules and regulations. Means if you want to print something or a statement, you have to begin the bracket, in the course the message will be there, then you have to close the bracket. One thing student I want to tell you, in Python everything is case sensitive. Case sensitive matlab where capital letters are different from the small letters. Okay, mostly in Python we are writing in the small letters, means whatever according to the Python, that will be in small. But if something is capital, then it should be capital everywhere. If something is small, then it should be small everywhere. So now you see, this is print hello, I am doing Python. So this is the message. Message can be in any form because it is under that, it is in your control. Okay, so now this one, suppose you want to ignore the line of code in your program, then put hash sign before that. Now you see, I put hash, this is becomes comment now. It has no use for the interpreter. Matlab ye line kabhi print hi nahi hui, interpreter ignore this line. Press F5. Okay, so you see the one line will be printed. Okay, say I am going to copy this. This line I am going to print twice again in the next line. So I want to ignore these two lines. So you can do multi-line comment also. Put triple quotes from the beginning of line up to where. Put end there triple quotes. Now these two lines will be treated as a comment which will be ignored by the interpreter. Now see the output. So you see that both lines are ignored and the last one is printed. So in that way you can give single line comment and multi line comment. To give the single line comment, put hash sign. To give the multi line comment, put triple quotes there. Okay, so I hope that today's lecture, the introductory part of Python as well as the print statement and interactive mode and script mode is clear to you. So whenever we have the live class, we will proceed further. So if you have any doubt, you can ask me anytime. Okay, student. So thank you. Have a nice day.